After Effects is one of those programs that even if you're a total pro at it, there's always going to be hidden features and tools that you don't know about until somebody else shows you. Even after more than 12 years of working with this program, I still find out stuff about it all the time that I didn't know about. Here are 7 of the lesser known features and tools that I find really useful in my work that you might not know about. First up is Motion Sketch, which is a way to very easily draw out the path you want your object to animate along. You won't find it in the effects panel by default. You'll find it being all coy over here under the window menu, and then just select Motion Sketch. Then it'll show up in the effects panel. You've got options for showing the background, so if you want your object or layer or character or whatever to go to specific points in your background, you can have that on. If you've got wireframe on, it shows the box around the layer so you know the size of the layer. All you need to do is press Start Capture, and then you grab the layer and sketch out the path you want it to take. And it goes at the speed you draw the path, so if you see here, if I do it really slowly, you can see all those dots are the frames. They're pretty close together, so that's going to be pretty slow. But if I did it fast, the dots are further apart and it animates much faster. Of course, you can still adjust the timing of the keyframes here by selecting them all and holding down Alt and dragging the last one, or you can adjust them individually. You can even use Auto Orient to orient it along the path so that it turns as the path turns. You either just use the shortcut Ctrl+Alt+O and the Auto Orient box will pop up, or you can right click on the layer, go to Transform and then Auto Orient and select Orient along path, and then it'll turn as the path turns too. Tip number 2. This is a tip to speed up your workflow if you need to know the time or duration or amount of frames between 2 keyframes. Instead of trying to count the frames manually, which I used to do, or work it out by subtracting one from the other, all you need to do is hold down Alt, click on the first one, and then click on the second one, and the amount of frames between the two will appear in the info panel. Might save you a lot of time you'd have otherwise spent on counting, and who's got time for that? Tip 3 is for if you have audio, and you need to time something to it. Like if you have a layer that needs to react to the beat of some music. Instead of trying to look at the waveform and manually time it to that, you can easily work smarter and not harder, and convert the audio to keyframes and use that to animate with or link the layer to. You select the audio layer, right-click and go to Keyframe Assistant, then convert audio to keyframes. It'll analyze the audio and create this audio amplitude layer. And when you press U to see the keyframes, you'll see we've got keyframes for the left and right channels, and also one for both. So you can usually delete the left and right and just work with the one for both, unless, you know, you've got specific requirements where you want to use the one or the other. But I'm going to delete them, and if you open up the graph editor, you'll see it almost like a waveform. There's a spike where there's a beat, except it's in keyframes. So that's already cool. But you can take this a step further and link your layer to the keyframes. For example, if you have a layer and you wanted to change color to the beat, let's say you have 2 main colors and you wanted to go between them to the beat of the music. You could do that manually, but that'd be pretty freaking tedious, and I'm hoping you've got better things to do with your time. So you could rather just create the layer that needs to change color. So I've got the solid, and I'm going to add a change to color effect here, and it'll change from the solid original color to this new color. Now on the layer, under compositing options, I'm going to use the effect opacity and link that to the beat in the audio amplitude layer. So I Alt-click on the stopwatch next to Effect Opacity and use the Pickwhip to link it to the slider under Audio Amplitude. And now the opacity of the effect is linked to the beat and it changes between those 2 colors according to the beat. Obviously it works with other things, like if you need something to scale up and down according to the beat, I'll just create the shape. Then I'll press S to bring up the scale property. Alt-click on the stopwatch next to it and pickwhip that to the audio amplitude slider here. And there you go, it scales to the beat of the audio without you having to do it manually. Now you might have noticed when I was picking the colors for the layer for the previous tip that I didn't have the typical color wheel that you have by default. I've got this sort of ugly looking system color picker. It might not be pretty, but it's really useful if you work a lot with specific color palettes, you know, instead of having swatches that you keep having to eyedrop from or whatever. So that's tip number 4, the system color picker. If you need to work with a specific palette or set of colors and you don't want to keep eyedropping them, you can create and save palettes in your color picker by just going into Edit, Preferences, and then General, and check Use System Color Picker. And then the color picker will be different and you can set a palette by adding custom colors here. Very cool if you're working with brand CIs, and just generally it's good for any design or motion design work to have a harmonious palette that you're working with and not always having to pick colors from other layers. Tip 5 is using guide layers. This is useful for if you need to have a guide for something. Say, if you have an object that needs to stay within certain bounds, or you have some notes on your screen, or maybe you're using a layer as a reference. You need it to be visible while you're working in that comp. But you don't want to have to turn it off every time you go to check the main comp that this one is nested in. Or you don't want to have to go find it and turn it off every time you render. All you need to do is set it as a guide layer by right-clicking on the layer and selecting guide layer. You'll see it in your current comp, but not the ones it's nested in, and it won't be there when you render. Tip 6. Now, I'm sure a lot of you do know this, but I've actually known some pretty experienced motion designers who didn't know this, so I'm just putting it out there. If you have a layer in your comp and you need to replace it with some other layer or artwork, you can just select the layer in the comp, select the layer you want to replace it with in the project panel, then hold down Alt and drag the new artwork down onto the layer you want to replace. It'll update the artwork, but it'll keep the keyframes and effects that you applied to that layer. Very cool if you had to animate with placeholders and then need to replace it with final artwork or do updates to the artwork or anything like that. Tip number 7 is shift parent. When you parent an object to a layer, but you also want it to have the parent layer's properties. For example, when you want a layer to snap to the same position as the parent layer, or you want a smaller shape to be exactly centered to a bigger shape without having to figure it out yourself. To parent something, you probably know that you just pickwhip the child layer to the one you want to be the parent. But if you hold down Shift, the child layer will take on the parent layer's properties, so it'll snap to the same position as well as the same scale. And then you see if you move the parent layer around, it'll react the same way. It's now parented to it. And those are just some of the tips that even pros might not know. Hopefully you learned something. If not, hopefully you were mildly entertained. If not even that, hopefully I provided some background noise for you while you did something else. Thank you to my beautiful patrons for all the support in the chats. In case the rest of you didn't know, I do have a Patreon page where I will sometimes post work in progress. I'll post resources to other stuff that I find online. And to some of my tiers, I also give monthly feedback on submitted animation work that they've done. Give the video a like if you didn't hate it, and maybe subscribe if you want to learn more about animation and motion graphics. Love ya, bye!